Coronaviruses are a large family of viruses that are known to cause illnesses ranging from the common cold to the more severe diseases such as the Middle East Respiratory Syndrome and the Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome SARS. A novel coronavirus, or the SARS CoV-2, is a new strain of coronavirus that has not been previously identified in humans. Coronavirus spreads from person to person through small air droplets. Let's say a person with COVID-19 sneezes or exhales in front of you, and you inhale the viral particles coming out of his mouth. The virus will then travel to the respiratory system. Epithelial cells of your bronchi, which are the main airways in your lungs, bronchial, the smaller passageways, and the most important, the tiny air sacs at the end, called the alveoli, are the main targets. Epithelial cells are like the safety shields of the body, forming a covering of all the body's surfaces. Unfortunately, they are prime cellular targets of the novel coronavirus because of the ACE2 receptors, which act as entry points. The virus then enters the cell using the spike protein on its surface that binds on a receptor of the target cells. Viruses have their own genetic code, but they lack the machinery to copy their DNA. So once inside, like a Trojan horse, the virus then hijacks and transforms the cell into a viral protein-making factory. The infected cells now serve the virus, synthesizing thousands and thousands of viral proteins and assembling them, which are later then released to enslave more cells and continue the process. As the infected cells die, they release proteins called cytokines and damage-associated molecular patterns. Cytokines are like the messenger proteins which act as a signal to activate the immune system. Then, macrophages, one of the most specialized cells in the immune system, gets activated. The macrophages then begin to secrete inflammatory cytokines, which results in the acute inflammation inside the lung. To be specific, they release IL-1, IL-6, IL-8, TNF-alpha, and IFN-gamma. These cytokines migrate to the capillaries that line the alveoli. Capillaries are the smallest blood vessels, having an endothelial lining comprised of endothelial cells. The inflammatory cytokines increase the spaces between the endothelial cells, causing the capillaries to leak. As the fluid from the capillaries start accumulating inside the alveoli, it becomes difficult to breathe. This condition is known as pneumonia. The inability to get enough oxygen into the lungs raises the risk for developing hypoxemia, where the blood oxygen level drops. Additionally, carbon dioxide will start accumulating inside, which is known as respiratory acidosis. As there's an increase in the secretion of cytokines, it will induce the expression of a very important molecule on the endothelial lining of the blood cells, called vesicular cell adhesion protein. This acts as a magnet. It attracts neutrophils to the site of the injury inside the alveoli. Neutrophils are white blood cells whose main function is to kill and clean out the invading pathogens. They kill the virus by secreting protease and reactive oxygen species, but it comes with a price, which is the damage of the tissue itself. The cycle will repeat, leading to more inflammation and more fluid accumulation. Type 1 alveolar cells, which are involved in the process of gas exchange between the alveoli and the blood, are damaged. Type 2 alveolar cells, which are responsible for making the alveoli open, also gets damaged. As a result, the alveoli will collapse, which will further contribute to the hypoxemia. Additionally, the cytokines secreted by the macrophages will result in the microscopic clotting of platelets and red blood cells called microthrombus, or a blood clot. This will lead to more hypoxemia and complete lung failure. As these cytokines are secreted into the system's circulation, they will have a very bad effect, causing abnormal blood clotting throughout the system. Blood clotting starts forming throughout the body, blocking small blood vessels. This is known as disseminated intravascular coagulation, which is a serious disorder. So it all began with a nasty cold and viral pneumonia. From acute respiratory distress syndrome, it has progressed to pulmonary embolism, and then ultimately led to multi-organ failure due to abnormal blood clotting throughout the body. It isn't the virus that kills you, but the way that your body reacts, or should I say, fails to react, against the virus that causes the death. Although there is no 100% effective treatment as of yet, we don't need to panic, as stress is only going to help the virus develop more. Remember, 94% of the patients recover from it despite the symptoms they show. Make sure to thoroughly wash your hands with alcohol-based hand rubs or soaps. Avoid any physical contact and stay away from crowds. And if you have any symptoms, remain calm and contact your local health services. Coronavirus really is not the end of the world, but we need to break the chain. Don't you think that our body is amazing, constantly fighting off infection and disease? Comment below your thoughts, and please subscribe for more wonderful videos. Thank you so much for watching. Stay happy, stay healthy, and stay curious.